Buenas noches, gracias por continuar con nosotros. En esta ocasión tenemos a nuestro dirigente Dave Jaus, luego de esta victoria. La misma mecánica, quienes tengan preguntas, pues la escriben en el chat a la derecha y con gusto, pues le cedemos el turno. Luis Tomás Rae tiene una pregunta, adelante. He said, what could you say about the first four games for the team?
Again, I'm going to answer the question. You can get tired of me answering the question this way, but we'll talk about tonight. Tonight was a game that we had good pitching, good defense, got the runs early, and it was, again, another good team effort that I thought we executed really, really well in getting runs early, putting the pressure on them, the pitching, throwing strikes, and being aggressive. Good job behind the plate by Julio. And then defense, all the plays.
Bueno, dice que prefiere hablar del juego de esta noche, que hubo un muy buen picheo por parte de todos los lanzadores, también gran defensa. También estuvo por ahí Julio haciendo su trabajo. Y se siente bastante contento del papel que jugó el equipo esta noche. Juan Arturo Recio tiene una pregunta. Adelante.
Good evening, Mr. Jaus. I have a question. This was an impressive team victory. You guys did all the right things against a complicated lineup like Gigantes. So what was the approach with pitching against these tough guys? For example, Ronald Guzman, Juan Francisco, Carlos Peguero, those guys. What was your approach against this lineup?
Well, it's a good call because it is a very good lineup. They're a powerful lineup. And the three guys you mentioned are all power hitters from the left side. So what you do is you use your pitches by getting ahead. You go to zones that they're not as comfortable in, and then you finish them off in pitches after you've gone to zones that they're not as comfortable in. We used all our pitches against them. We went to our strengths rather than their weaknesses because they don't have many. And then a couple times we did fall behind, we challenge them and make them try to hit in this ballpark, which is a really good pitcher's park on a night like today, and let the defense work.
Bueno, sobre la pregunta de cómo enfrentó a jugadores de poder del equipo de los Gigantes, dice que tienen jugadores muy buenos, de mucho poder, sobre todo esos que mencionó, pero que la idea era tratar de estar al frente en el conteo contra ellos y también buscar sus debilidades, que no son muchas, y sobre todo tener la ventaja de que estamos en un estadio grande donde no es fácil sacar la pelota. Bueno, mientras llega otra pregunta, Mr. Jaus, today we tried with a different lineup, so we had a great results. We will repeat this lineup next Friday, or we will try another one?
I'm going to let anybody on this Zoom call make the lineup for tomorrow. I won't make it. Because we're off tomorrow.
No, I know.
I'm just kidding, guys. I thought it was, hey, we won at home, and I wanted to have a little laugh on myself. But Friday, and you guys are going to ask me about lineups for the next day. I can't give you the lineup for the next day. I can give you the starting pitcher for the next game. But until players see who's in the lineup, I don't ever want them to hear it on a media Zoom meeting or in the newspaper or on TV or on radio. So just so you know. Now, from that, I liked our lineup today. I liked the way they played defense. I liked the way that they strung some at-bats together and put some runs on the board early. We didn't finish off some innings later where we had runners in scoring position and they made some pretty good pitches and we just didn't get another couple runs across the board. I would believe we will have a different line. I'm planning to have a different lineup on Friday. I can't tell you what it is right this moment because the players don't know it.
Bueno, sobre la pregunta de que como el lineup de hoy dio resultados ganando el partido, si repetiríamos ese lineup el próximo viernes, dice que no tiene esa respuesta porque ya vería el próximo viernes cuáles serían los jugadores que están. El de hoy sí funcionó, pero hay jugadores que están dando resultados. Tal vez no sea la misma alineación, pero tal vez sí los mismos jugadores. Pero hay que esperar al viernes para tener la respuesta a esa pregunta. David Hernández, de Pío Deportes.
Saludos al dirigente Dave Jaus y saludos a todos el panel. Mi pregunta va relacionada a la condición del jugador Chas McCormick, quien salió hoy, fue sustituido, y quisiéramos saber el estatus de salud de este jugador.
He said if you know some news about Chas McCormick because he was out of the game.
Yeah, he had his quad tightened at third base the time that he got the infield single and then went from second and then to third and was first and third, and he was trying to work it out there. He could have scored if he had to from third base with two outs, Filipito, and he talked out there and made sure that they were okay. But when he came in the dugout and he was working so hard to try to work the quad out in this early part of the year, with this weather, with these guys playing games for the first time, most of these players are playing games for the first time in real games in 14 months, and even spring training games in 9 months. There's no reason to put a guy out that's tight that all of a sudden you lose him for maybe 10 days. I know the training staff took care of him once we removed him. I know he'll get treatments tomorrow. I'm not sure it's going to be day-to-day even. I think there's a chance that he can play Friday by taking him out early. We will decide that on Friday.
Dice que tuvo un problemita corriendo en las bases, pero que es una situación que se da bastante un día como hoy, que el terreno estaba tan pesado por la lluvia, y además son jugadores que tenían meses sin jugar béisbol también, y su cuerpo se resiente bastante con este tipo de lesiones, pero espera que no sea algo de cuidado y confía en que el cuerpo técnico, los trainers del equipo, pueden hacer el trabajo para tenerlo listo en los próximos días. Tenemos una pregunta de Juan Arturo Recio. Adelante.
Yes, Mr. Yost, I want to go back to the point you made about leaving runners on bases. That's been something with the Escogido in these first games. You guys have been leaving a lot of runners on the bases. Do you think it has something to do with all the time the guys didn't play? We got to acknowledge the good pitching that we've seen so far, but what do you think is the main reason for all these runners staying on base?
I believe if you look, I would think that the other we've pitched well to keep their runners from scoring with two outs, other than the one game that Lissay had, what, 5 two-out runs early in the game? I think it was Lissay that did that.
Yep.
So I think some of it has to do with guys not having their timing because they haven't played. Some of it has to do with good pitching. Some of it's got to do with just baseball. Because in the middle of the season, sometimes in July in major leagues, in December in Dominican or Venezuela in winter leagues, this same thing can happen. So you go through stretches, and then you'll go through stretches where there's seven games where, boy, you're driving in every two-out run. I do believe, though, that we have a long lineup, 1 through 9, and we will be a team that has an opportunity to drive in two-out runs, because that is a big plus for me on championship clubs, is driving in two-out runs.
Dice que son cosas que pasan en el béisbol dominicano, en otras ligas del Caribe, incluso todavía en grandes ligas, hasta mitad de temporada, junio, julio, son cosas que suceden, porque todavía se está, digamos, que iniciando la temporada, pero espera que esa situación se pueda corregir, la de dejar corredores en base, que fue la pregunta que hizo el amigo. Entonces, espera que poder corregir esa situación con los lineups que ha estado integrando y moviendo, para ver cómo se reduce al mínimo esa cantidad de corredores en circulación dejados en base y poder capitalizar esa estadística. Arvin González. Arvin wrote, Gregory Polanco is expected to join the team during the weekend. Have talked with the front office about the way you're going to use him?
Well, I do not like to almost like talking about a lineup the next game. I don't like to talk about players that aren't on the roster, but because it's Gregory, I will talk about some things about him, because the man is a really close man to me. I've been able to be with him in the dugout in the major leagues for the last several years, previous to 2020. And our plan is to have him, when he's ready, play and hit in the middle of the lineup. He'll play some outfield, right field. He'll take time in the DH. And we will work our lineup accordingly. And he will be part of the team. Every time he's in on the roster, he'll be the same part of the team as Julio Rodriguez in an outfielder, and Cesar Puello as an outfielder, Melky Mesa as an outfielder, Chaz McCormick as an outfielder. He'll be no different, and that's the way he wants it, because I know the man really well, and he is a tremendous man. Great baseball player, but a tremendous man.
Bueno, dice que sobre la pregunta de cómo utilizará Gregory Polanco cuando juegue, que está practicando ya, dice que la intención es utilizarlo en el medio del lineup, en los jardines también, como bateador designado, pero lo importante es utilizarlo cuando esté listo, cuando esté en forma para jugar, porque hay muchos jardineros en el equipo que también están trabajando fuerte, pero la idea es que Gregory Polanco, que conoce desde hace mucho tiempo y que ha trabajado de cerca con él, que se integre cuando esté completamente en forma para aportar al equipo. Johanna Núñez.
Good night, guys. Good night, Mr. Joss. Tonight, then you raced through four strong innings. What was the game plan with his first outing in the Dominican Winter League?
It was about Denji Reyes?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. My hearing, there's like air conditioning here. I don't hear real well.
Okay, what was the...
Oh, the bus is outside. I got you.
Okay, what was the game plan with Denji Reyes in this first outing in the Dominican
Denji Winter League? Denji was tremendous. He commanded the zone. He was aggressive on the mound. He took the game plan in and executed it. Good poise on the mound. That's a winning pitcher, in the Dominican, and a developing pitcher to have a long career as a pitcher in professional baseball.
Bueno, sobre el plan de juego, la salida que tuvo hoy Denji Reyes, dice que fue extraordinaria, pudo capitalizar los buenos picheos que tiró hoy, sacando los outs importantes, y espera que en lo adelante pueda seguir mejorando y convertirse en un gran lanzador, como dio muestras hoy, tirando esas cuatro entradas en blanco contra los Gigantes del Cibao. Concluimos con David Hernández.
Jaos, su valoración, opinión sobre la profundidad en el picheo en una temporada que es reducida, ¿qué tan importante es para usted como dirigente y para los Leones del Escogido en sus aspiraciones para llegar a los playoffs?
He's asking about the pitchers, because we have great pitchers and many pitchers, especially because this is a short season. What does it mean for you?
The most important part of pitchers is get him on the mound. Get him comfortable on the mound. Get their arms strong, their body strong, and work on their pitches and getting people out. In this game of baseball, it's about results. Short season or long season, yes, we have to evaluate sooner. Yes, pitchers have to execute a little bit sooner. They don't have time to work their way into it. But these guys are all pros. They're all men. And they're going to take the ball and they're going to do their best each time out so that they get outs, prevent runs, and then get ready for the next time where they'll be a little bit better, because hitters will get a little bit better because they'll have seen more pitches and have more at-bats, and their timing being better, so the pitcher get better. And they will, and I do like our pitching. I think we have a number of pitchers to use in different roles, in all sorts of roles, and they are going to make the decisions, good, tough decisions for us, because there'll be some really good pitchers that won't be used as frequently as the best pitchers we have.
Dice que sí, es importante tener pitchers saludables, con brazos saludables, fuertes. No importa si es una temporada corta o si es una temporada larga, lo importante es tener un buen staff de pitcheo que pueda conducir los partidos. Y la idea es que traten de ser un poco mejor cada vez que vayan a lanzar, porque los bateadores van a ser cada vez más complicados a medida que avance la liga. Pero sí, lo importante es tratar de tener esos brazos sanos y que puedan responder al momento de tomar la decisión de quién va a lanzar o abrir un partido o lanzar durante el medio del juego. Mr. Jaws, thank you very much for this time. Gracias a todos los periodistas, amigos, conectados con nosotros. Será hasta un próximo encuentro. Buenas noches.